Welcome to USGS video training for collecting and processing water quality data. The USGS has a reputation for water data that are reliable and impartial. Our data are used by many agencies and scientists to seek to understand and manage our nation's water resources. The water mission area of the USGS has an important responsibility to collect data that accurately describe the physical, chemical, and biological attributes of our nation's water systems. To accomplish this, USGS has developed a National Field Manual for the collection of water quality data. The National Field Manual provides documentation and consistency in our scientific methods. It maintains the accuracy of our data, and it sharpens our technical expertise. This video series supplements the National Field Manual with focused training on selected field techniques.
This video presents the types, limitations, and operation of churn splitters. Churns are simple to operate, easy to clean, constructed from polymer or plastic material, and available in 8-liter and 14-liter sizes.
Churn splitters, or churns, are used to combine subsamples as they are collected from several points in a stream or river. The churn is then used to split the combined water samples into sample bottles that represent the suspended and dissolved concentrations in the stream or river. The advantages and limitations of churns are described in Table 2-6 in Chapter 2 of the National Field Manual. The plastic churn should be used to process samples for inorganic analyses. The polymer churn can be used for either inorganic or non-volatile organic analyses.
The original spigot on the plastic churn contains a metal spring that was found to be a source of metal contamination and must be replaced if the churn is to be used to process samples for trace element analysis. The spigot can be replaced by the manufacturer with non-contaminating components. There are several limitations to churns, including sediment size and concentration. The size of the sediment particles cannot exceed 250 microns. The total sediment concentration cannot exceed 1,000 milligrams per liter. The maximum volume for the 14-liter churn is 13 liters, and the maximum volume for the 8-liter churn is 7 liters. After all samples are withdrawn from the churn, the water level inside the churn should be at least 2 inches above the spigot inlet. Churns are not approved for some microbiology sample processing. See Chapter 7 of the National Field Manual for additional details.
While wearing disposable gloves, remove the churn splitter and inner bag from the churn carrier and place it on a level surface. The Dirty Hands team member churns the splitter throughout the sample processing at a uniform rate of 9 inches per second by raising and lowering the disc inside the churn with smooth, even strokes. When churning, the disc should touch the bottom of the churn on every stroke, and the stroke length should be as long as possible without breaking the water surface.
For proper disc alignment, insert the disc with the groove mated with the alignment guide inside the churn. Before withdrawing any sample, pre-mix the sample by churning with 10 strokes to uniformly disperse the suspended material. The churning rate should be about 9 inches per second. Inadequate churning can result in non-representative samples.
If the churning rate is significantly greater than 9 inches per second, or if the disc breaks the water surface, excessive air is introduced into the sample, and that could affect dissolved gases, bicarbonate, pH, and other sample characteristics. Do not interrupt the churning or subsampling process. If an interruption occurs, re-establish the churning rate to remix the sample by churning 10 strokes at the proper rate before continuing.
As the volume of the composite sample in the churn decreases, adjust the stroke length to maintain a churning rate of about 9 inches per second and continue to avoid breaking the water surface within the churn.
Samples should be withdrawn from the churn in order of volume, largest to smallest. Empty the churn after all bottles have been processed. If the churn will be reused in the field, disassemble it and clean it on site while it is still wet, as described in National Field Manual Chapter 3.
If the churn will not be reused during the field trip, rinse it with DI water before it dries out, place it in a plastic bag and in the churn carrier for transportation back to the office laboratory for cleaning. Complete the field form and notes to document the type of churn used. For additional information regarding selection, cleaning, collection, processing, and churn splitters, see chapters 2, 3, 4, and 5 of the National Field Manual.